Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Root Yoga Therapy. I'm your certified yoga therapist, Jasmine Leventhal, and today's practice is going to be focused on postpartum anxiety and depression. Now, I know that the sensations of these two emotions can feel completely different, but they also can coexist and they actually can feed off one another. So we're going to focus on a practice that's going to not only ground you, but invigorate you in a really balanced way. So it's not going to feel scattered, it's going to feel controlled, and hopefully it'll give you a feeling of health and ease and joy. Hop into something comfy and join me on your mat. Welcome back. So for this practice, we're going to be doing some solid standing poses because it really helps bring in and centralize some energy. So with that being said, we're actually going to start in a standing position. So finding yourself in a comfortable stance. Now, the standing position is actually very active. So you're going to find that balancing around all four points of the feet. And by four points, I mean the inner and outer heel and the inner and outer foot. So already find that sense of grounding and connection with the earth. Soften your eyes to close. And let's place one hand on our heart, one hand on the belly. And this again just kind of draws that energy inward, draws our focus and attention inward. And we'll start here again with the feet. So feeling that sturdiness and allowing that strength and sturdiness to move up into the lower legs, lifting gently up on the kneecaps to activate the upper legs, drawing the navel in to kind of pull the energy upward and towards the chest, opening up across your shoulders, and then allowing the back of your body to grow taller, the spine to lengthen, and the crown of the head to extend skyward. And finding your breath in through the nose and exhaling through the nose. And we can work with an even breath to start. So taking two count inhale, one, two, and a two count exhale, one, two. Inhaling, one, two, and exhaling for one, two. And just following that rhythm and that cadence. Now, if you feel like you can take a longer inhale and longer exhale, please go ahead and do that. And ideally, we'd like to be working towards a slightly longer exhalation. So if you're taking a two count inhale, work towards a three count exhale. And we'll take a few cycles of breath here just so you can find a rhythm that's going to support yourself and your practice through our time together. And then once you have that, slowly releasing your hands down towards your side, blink your eyes open, taking an inhale, reach your arms skyward, interlace all but the index finger and thumb, and start to move your body towards the left, stretching through the right. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, over to the right, stretching through the left. And two more on each side, again, just with your own breath. One more on each side. And coming back to center and releasing your hands down. Do some shoulder rolls, lifting shoulders up, back, and down for one, two, and last one, three. Good. Make your way to the front of your mat. Take an inhale, reach your arms skyward, full breath. Exhale, fold it forward. Inhale, extend your chest forward. And as you exhale, step your left toes back, pause here, release your left knee down. Good. As you inhale, walk your hands towards your right thigh. Exhale, find yourself in that lower lunge. If you feel good here and balanced, stay right here. If you want to go further, you can bring your hands to your hips, hands to your heart, or hands overhead. Good, taking a full breath in. As you exhale, release your hands down. Tuck your left toes, straighten your back leg, and then step your right foot back, downward facing dog position. Inhale, coming forward into a plank or modified plank on the knees. It's totally up to you, your strength, however you're feeling today. Take one more inhale here. Exhale, tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Good, two more. Inhale to plank. If you're doing a plank, hold plank position, otherwise modified plank on the knees. Exhale, curl the toes, downward facing dog. And last one, inhaling. Release the knees. And curl the toes, downward facing dog. Good, take a full breath in. As you exhale, gaze forward, gently walk your feet up towards your hands, folding at the top of your mat. Bend your knees slightly, find a chair pose, sitting your hips back. Now feet should be hips distance apart here, otherwise feet are together, heels slightly apart. See if you can drop a little lower and rise up on your inhale. Exhale, hand to heart. So kind of getting right into it. Inhale, sweep the arms skyward. Exhale, fold it forward. Inhale, lengthen out. Exhale, right leg steps back, right knee drops down. Pausing here, walking your hands to the top of your left thigh. Now any variation with the hands that you did on the right, try and do that here. Finding your balance, so hands to hips, hands to heart, or hands skyward. Taking one more inhale. Exhale, releasing hands down. Tuck your back toes, straighten your back leg, slide that left leg out, downward facing dog. Inhale, glide forward, plank or plank on the knees. Exhale, down dog. Two more. Inhale to plank or plank on the knees. Exhale to down dog, moving through core center. Inhale. And exhale. Good, shifting your gaze forward, gently walk feet to hands, folding at the top of your mat. Feet are hips distance or toes together, heels apart. Bend the knees, chair pose, reach the arms forward and up. See if you can get down a little lower. Root down, rise up, hands to heart center. Good, inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, release the hands to the mat, fold. Inhale, chest forward. As you exhale, just step your left leg back, keep the right knee bent, and pause here. Maybe walk your right knee to the right about an inch or two. Find that nice low lunge. Your hands can stay here, aligning your front foot. Maybe this is where you bring your blocks into play. For something stronger, draw your right hip in, sweep your arms back behind you. Good, breathe here, wherever you are, either hands on the by the foot or hands sweeping back. As you exhale, hands down, you're gonna step your back foot forward, folding. Find your chair pose, bend your knees, release your hips, stretch your arms forward and up. Sink a little bit lower, drawing the navel in. Exhale, root down, rise up, hands to heart. Inhale, sweep the arms skyward. Exhale, fold it in. As you inhale, lift the heart and step the right toes back. Walk your left foot a couple inches over to the left to find yourself a little more balanced. And then hands are going to stay here on the mat, on the blocks or the mat, or they're going to sweep back behind you. Take a full breath in. As you exhale, releasing your hands down. Pause here, step it forward, folding in, and finding that chair pose. Bend the knees, drop the hips, reach the arms forward and up. Good, root down, rise up, hands to heart, exhale. Good, inhale, sweep the arms skyward. Exhale, fold in. Good, move your blocks off your mat and then gently step back. Releasing the knees down, plank on the knees, slowly lowering chest, chin, belly, hips to the mat. Good, from here, place your hands with the palm side down and then lift your shoulders away from the mat. Forehead can stay on the mat. Tops of the feet are pressing, lift the kneecaps. As if you're pulling the mat away from your head, inhale, lift your chest. Just a gentle back bend. Exhale, release. Now we're doing this gently to open up the front of the heart. Also, like when we're feeling maybe sad or depressed, we might have rounding in the shoulders, blocking off the heart space. But we also don't want to invigorate too much because they can be really energizing in kind of like we don't want to trigger our anxious feelings. So we just want to be nice and balanced. Inhale, gently lift the heart. Exhale, release. And you're using a lot of back strength for this. Last one, inhale. Exhale. Good. Placing your hands up by your ribs, taking an inhale. Gentle cobra pose, press up, downward facing dog. So back bends can be tricky when working with feelings of anxiety or depression. They can be really invigorating, which is great if we're feeling sluggish. But they can also trigger more of an ungrounded feeling. So we want to just work the back bend in a way that's going to open up the heart, use a lot of strength, keep it nice and controlled, and not go too deep, even though you may know that you can just by your natural flexibility. Just want to be kind of aware and conscious of that. Take one more in-breath here. As you exhale, walk your hands all the way back to your feet, folding at the back of your mat. Good, we're gonna separate the feet as wide as the mat. Take a slight bend into your right leg, planting your right fingertips towards the front of your right toes, and then inhale, open your chest with the left arm. And then releasing it down. And switch, bending into the left knee. Maybe you're on the fingertips or palm of the hand is down. Open up. And release. Good, coming back to center. Inhale, lengthen out. Keep your feet as wide as they are. Walk back out, wide, kind of downward facing dog. Good, now walk the feet back, hips distance. Inhale, release the right leg up and back behind you. As you exhale, draw the right knee up towards your chest. Step, scooch, walk that foot forward. And then spin your back heel down. Take that wider stance again. If this is too much already on your hips, you can keep the back heel off the mat and come more into a crescent pose. Otherwise, warrior one. Full breath in. And then pausing here. Work that front leg straight. Hands to hips, take an inhale, lean your chest forward and up. And then as you exhale, we're gonna fold over your front leg. Folding forward, 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 grab those blocks on the way down and take a nice fold here. Pull your right hip back. Good, one more inhale. Exhale, re-bend into your right leg, and then pause, spin onto those back toes. Walk your block slightly forward. We're gonna come up into a little standing split position. So press forward and slowly lift the back foot off the mat. Keep the hips nice and square. As you exhale, draw your left knee in towards your chest and release the left foot down. Good, inhale, root down, rise up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, fold in. Inhale, lengthen out. And exhale, step that right foot back. Either you're gonna stay on the ball of the back foot or spin the heel down. And then walk the left foot over to the left, coming into that warrior one position. Inhale, arms reach forward and up. Woo, my balance, warrior one. Good, keep anchoring through the back foot and back leg. Next, hands are gonna come to the hips. Good, lean your chest upward, find that space. And then as you exhale, work your front leg straight, land your hands onto your blocks. Lengthen out, always looking for length in the spine, grounding in the feet, strengthen the legs. One more in-breath, start to walk the blocks forward, bend into your left foot, start to shift the weight and the strength into that left leg, hover the right toes off the mat, maybe taking that right leg almost up to hip height. And then as you exhale, curl that right knee in towards your chest and release the foot down. Inhale, lengthen forward. Exhale, fold, root down, rise up on your in-breath. Exhale, hands to heart. Good. Facing forward on your mat, grounding down into your left leg, we're gonna start with tree pose. So you can balance here with your toes on the mat and your heel resting on the inner ankle. You can take that foot to the inner shin, just not on the knee, or you can take the foot up to the inner thigh. Ooh, do I have the balance today? I don't know. Find a gazing point, so that could be down. Usually when I look forward and down, it helps me balance, and then once I feel really grounded and rooted, I can start to shift my gaze. Bring hands to heart. You can do it how we started, one hand on the heart, one hand on the belly. Or you can take your hands overhead. And one more breath. As you exhale, slowly release the hands down and release the foot down. And shake out that standing leg and shift. So working on the right side, again, same variation. So if you were here, even if you feel like you can go further, just stay here and try and work balance on both sides. Otherwise, do whatever other variation you did. Take a moment, find your drishti, your focus point, somewhere forward and down. Engage the outer hips by hugging towards the midline, bringing in hands in either prayer, one hand over heart, one hand over belly, or overhead. And find that evenness of breath or that extended exhale breathing. One more inhale. As you exhale, gently release. Ooh, and release the foot down. Good, shake out that standing leg. Good, take a nice wide stance on your mat. Roll your heels in, toes out. Bring your hands to the tops of your thighs. Come into a goddess squat. And then once you feel grounded, you can stay here, or you can bring the hands to the heart. And breathing here. Again, lots of strength in the legs, lots of grounding in the lower body, opening across the chest. So it's like a game of finding these really grounding poses to help kind of balance the anxious, ungrounded feelings, kind of that feeling of being all over the place, and then also invigorating poses at the same time to take away that sluggish, slow, lethargic feeling, that heaviness that the depression, the sensations of depression can bring in. Taking one more inhale. And then as you exhale, come on up. Really good. Wrap the toes inward. Inhale, arms reach skyward. Exhale, fold it forward. Options here for hands. They can land on blocks. They can land on the mat or take into the outer edges of the ankles. Or fourth option, hook the big toe and take that toe hand lock. Again, any kind of touching with the feet can be really grounding for feelings of anxiousness. One more breath in. And exhale, gently release. Slowly come up. Good. Feet together. Move your props somewhere where you'll be able to grab them when we're on our backs. And let's move on to our back. So we're gonna take a block. You can start with this flat height, place it underneath your hips. And this is just a supported bridge pose. It's one of my favorite poses. It's extremely restorative. It's very healing. And just allow your body to kind of melt around that block. And then when you feel really softened here, you can start to, and steady, you can start to take your feet maybe in a bent-kneed position away from the mat, and then eventually upward. And slowly re-bend into the knees. If you extended the legs, plant the feet down. Pause here. Extend your right leg forward and down. Get that stretch through the psoas muscle into the belly. Oftentimes when we're anxious, we can tense up in the gut and the psoas muscle gets really tight. It also gets tight if we're sitting a lot and we're feeling lethargic. So this is a great way to stretch this. If you're feeling any kind of tension in your lower back, you can remove yourself off the block and just simply do this flat on your back. Good. Bend back into your right knee, plant the foot, switch, left leg forward. Get that stretch through the psoas. It's like our hip flexor, it extends all the way into the belly, kind of wraps into the lower back. So it's really important that we continue to lengthen this as much as we can because it's often shortened and it can be the cause of a lot of lower back pain. Good, re-bend into your left knee. Press into your feet, lift your hips. Find just that little gentle bridge for a moment, remove the block from underneath you and slowly moving your way down towards the mat. And pause here. Take an inhale, scoop your legs in towards you, give them a nice squeeze, and then shift up. Come into a seated position. Extend your legs forward. Inhale, reach your arms forward and up. Exhale, fold hamstring stretch. If you can't reach your feet, my dirty feet, you can grab your shins, your ankles. You can place your hands by your side. Remember to lengthen through your back body. And slowly come on up. Good. Butterfly pose. Lifting the chest. You can pause here or you can begin to fold, extending your arms forward. Keeping this pose active by continuing to feel your knees move out towards either side of your mat, your chest pulling beyond your toes, the crown of the head moving forward, tailbone anchoring back. And slowly walk your hands back towards your feet. Good. Bring your hands to the outsides of your knees and bring them in. Stretch them out one more time. Give them a little shake and then find a nice cross leg. Pausing here, taking an inhale. Swoop your arms up overhead. Open mouth, exhale as the hands come to heart. Inhale, arms overhead. Open mouth, exhale. Good, I want to conclude the practice with a alternate nostril breathing. So I'll guide you through a couple of rounds. We'll take a couple of rounds on our own. and then we'll conclude our practice together. Whether you want to sit in meditation, or take a full shavasana, or end with me, completely your choice, depending on how much time you have. So finding yourself in a nice, comfortable position, we're going to do some alternate nostril breathing. It helps balance both sides of the body. It's really good for well-being, just to improve a sense of emotional well-being. And it's safe no matter what stage of postpartum you're in. So pausing here. So we can do this with two ways, either with your pointer fingers kind of alternating like this, or I like to use just my pinky and my thumb and alternate like this. I just find it a little easier. We're going to start off by closing the left nostril. You'll take an inhale through your right nostril. Pause, close off the right, exhale down the left. Inhale up the left. Pause, exhale down the right. That counts as one full cycle. We'll just continue that way, inhaling up the right. Pause, close off the right, exhale down the left. Inhaling up the left. Pause, switch, exhale down the right. Inhaling up the right. Pause, switch, exhale down the left. Inhale up the left. Pause, switch, exhale down the right. Just go a few more cycles on your own. If you make a mistake with the breath, it's okay. But what I love about this is that it really forces you to focus on exactly what you're doing in this moment. So for those of us who are anxious, it's often because we're thinking about something not in this present moment. And this breath will absolutely force you to think about what you're doing in this moment. Take one more cycle. Release your hand down once you're done. Take a breath in through both nostrils. Out through both nostrils. Thank you so much for joining me in this practice. I hope you're feeling a little more well-balanced, maybe a little more energized, and definitely more grounded. I hope to see you next time. Namaste.